now we need to actually finish the setup. Now, this is a little bit simpler than our other ones. The hardest thing is creating the controls, and it's just the eyelid, just making something that looks visually interesting, but you can do simpler things as well. But let's get this together. So we have a couple of things here. We have our body, we have this, so let's create some groups. Create our world group. And really, I probably should also create a character group as well too, so I'm going to change this up this time as well and get back to some things I used to do. So character, world goes in the character. Create one for our controls. Geo. And scale. Controls is just going to go in the world. Scale is going to go in the world. And geo is going to go in the scale. Let's get all of our controls in the controls group. So I'm just going to select them. So I'm going to go in the controls group. My geometry. I'm going to go in the geo group. Now, let's select our character control. Select our scale group. Constraint. And we're going to do a parent constraint. And we're also going to do a scale constraint. And the reason I'm not going to the option box is I know maintain offset is already on, so I don't have to worry about that. And it moves, but we have a problem. What's that problem? None of our controls are moving with it. What were you about to say?
I said there was also
going to
be a double transformation.
Well, it's not a double transformation. It's moving. But that's because it's looking at the control. Right. So we got to get our controls to move with this as well. But we also want to kind of do this in a way that still allows us some freedom in case something breaks. That we don't lose everything. So what we're going to do is I am going to take these controls. I'm sorry, I'm going to take my eyelid controls and my eyelid con, and I'm going to group them. And I'm going to modify, I'm going to center that pivot, and I'm going to just name this icons group. And I'm going to do this, I'm going to select my main controller, I'm going to select that group, and what we're going to do is go do a parent constraint and a scale constraint. So it moves together. And it scales as well. Scale constraint. Let's finish our setup. So my character group, I'm locking all of this down. World group, same thing. My controls, same thing. Icon group, very much so. this case, translate Z and Y because of the orientation of my character. And I'm going to hide the rest of these. Those are locked. This stays open. We have our groups locked down. And I'm going to go ahead and do something just a little bit different. And we need to start kind of locking down things that could potentially be accessed and that can break our rig. Let's hold off on that just right now. Eventually, we're going to start locking these two things down that I've said earlier. And we could go ahead and lock them down now. Just select them all, lock and hide selected. Now, if you have a problem, that means there's more stuff you have to unlock and hide later on. And then we can also do these